Breakfast Club, bitches.
You're a donkey.
Oh, donkey of the day for Wednesday, April 17th goes to the man known throughout the world as Wendy Williams' husband, soon to be Wendy Williams' ex-wife, Kelvin Hunter. His government name is Kelvin. They call him Kevin. Personally, I just thank God that I haven't had to call him in 10 plus years. Now, let the record show I love, value, and appreciate all black men out there. In fact, I love people, period. But it's only two people on this planet I don't give a damn about, and Kelvin Hunter is one of them. I don't have time to tell you all the backstory between me and that guy. You can go buy my New York Times best-selling book, Black Privilege, to get the origin story. In a nutshell, I worked with and sometimes lived with Kelvin Hunter and Wendy Williams. That period was about 4 years of my life, so I am very well versed on the subject of Kelvin Hunter. Now, if you want to know why I don't rock with Kelvin Hunter anymore, I have told you all that we stopped communicating in February of 2010 because he got upset that his mistress, now baby mama, Sharina Hudson, a.k.a. Nikki, from Columbia, South Carolina, drop on the clues bombs for the 803. He got upset because he thought I was trying to hook his mistress up with my homeboy Wax. Think about that. Big grown-ass married Negro from Brownsville, Brooklyn, supposed to be some thorough-ass hood dude, upset because he thinks I'm trying to hook his side chick up with my homeboy. Does that not make him a grade-A sucker? Mm. A clown of legendary proportions. Now, the reason I have never had no smoke for Wendy is, number one, I feel sorry for her because she was an abused woman on various levels. And two, I know Kelvin didn't go to Wendy and say, yeah, we don't rock with Charlamagne anymore because he tried to hook his side chick up with my homeboy. So you just chalk that up to the game. Keep it moving. So after February of 2010, I stopped communicating with him and continued to live my life like it was golden. Never paid this dude any mind. But from the time I started doing the Breakfast Club and various times over the past 9 years, any chance he's gotten to take a shot at me or kick my back in or block a bag or an opportunity, oh, he's took it. Envy, do you remember when we first started the Breakfast Club 9 years ago?
Yes.
Did Kevin Hunter not reach out to you?
Yes, he did.
What did he say?
He said you were a fake, a backstabber, disloyal, a sucker. Short and gay.
Shut up.
he said all of that.
I knew you was gonna add something. I just knew it.
I told you what he said to me, right?
What did he say to you?
I ran into him and Wendy at an event, and it was before I even knew we were doing the Breakfast Club.
Okay.
I never told you this story?
I don't remember.
And I ran into them, and this was before we even had the Breakfast Club. This is when I had an offer to do a morning show in Philly.
Okay.
And he said, I heard you got an offer in Philly. They said, don't take that offer. Wait for New York. And then he said, watch out for Charlamagne, though, because he can't be trusted. And he is, what did they say? They said that you're, all you care about is yourself and that he'll stab you in the back.
Oh, okay. Okay.
And that you're short and gay.
Shut up! See, I was waiting. See, I know it was coming. I knew it was coming. Anyway.
And I said he's not that short.
All of that is true, except for the gay part. It was a producer who wanted to do a TV show with me once. He wanted to do it through Deadbar Mercury, which is the production company Wendy's daytime talk show is syndicated through. Kev blocked that, but I knew that was going to happen. I remember once he called my cousin Dana, salute to my cousin Dana, to threaten me physically for no damn reason at all. What I'm trying to tell you is, this man has actively tried to take my head off every chance he gets, but last year, it got really bad. See, if anyone wants to know why I really don't rock with Kelvin Hunter, look no further than an interview his former artist who lived with him all last year named Avion Foster did with Tasha K. Now, if you don't know who Avion is, he's a singer who used to be signed to Kelvin, and he claims he was sexually abused by Kelvin Hunter. His words, not mine. Let's listen.
He came over and practically raped me. He came over 3 o'clock in the morning. I know he was high. Come over like, pull back the covers. Now, I sleep naked. And I used to stay in the condo in Fort Lee, New Jersey. Now, mind you, I just did the number two. But he didn't care about that. He ate me. He spit me. And then put his in. Excuse me. And he in less than 30 seconds. And he, while he was stroking, he was like, yeah, this is Brownville's. Yeah.
Don't
bring Brooklyn into this, man.
Now, I don't know.
Shout out to Brownsville.
I don't know if those allegations are true or not, but if they are, just know Kelvin is really putting the brown in Brownsville, if it is.
And he doesn't last long at all. That's terrible.
Listen, man, nothing puts the brown in Brownsville like a doo-doo stained anus. Hey.
My goodness.
Now, that's Avion Foster. Remember last year, last summer, when a narrative was being created that I was a rapist? A sexual predator, all based off an old charge that I had in 2001 of criminal sexual conduct, which I have always spoken about, wrote about it in my book, never hid it from anybody, talked about this charge like I talked about all my other charges. Now, this charge was dismissed and expunged from my record simply because I took a DNA test and because the young woman didn't want to cooperate. If you take a DNA test and your DNA is not found in a woman's rape kit, then that's usually what happens. Your charges get dismissed. That was my case. But that didn't stop a narrative from being painted, especially when you couple that with old inappropriate jokes that I made when I was younger on The Breakfast Club, and take conversations about rape culture that I had on my podcast out of context. You put that with this young lady's side of the story. Easy to paint the narrative that Charlamagne is a rapist, especially in this era, in this Time's Up Me Too movement. You can vandalize someone's perception. You can do some damage to their business, and that's exactly, allegedly, what Kelvin Hunter tried to do to me. I knew this, but Avion Foster, who lived with Kelvin last year, confirmed it with Tasha K. Let's listen to that.
Kelvin's okay. Behind the whole thing because of some beef Nicki got with Charlamagne. Charlamagne don't even know what Nicki mad about. But when I was in Kevin's office, sitting back and forth between me and him, just like this.
Okay.
I was like, man, why are you doing this, man? He said, sometimes you just got to do something for the family, man.
Now you're talking about the allegations involving
Charlamagne
that reappeared via media, okay, of him supposedly raping.
Right, which is totally false. They didn't know that I was there when Phil was calling.
Who is Phil?
Phil is Kev's assistant, somebody who works with Kev. But I was there when I was on tour, on the Wendy tour. Kevin was right on the phone with this girl and her people organizing the story.
Now, my lawyer served Kelvin Hunter last summer and his publicist, Danny Astoria, because I was getting calls from blogs and other radio stations telling me Danny Astoria, who is their publicist, was calling around on behalf of Kelvin Hunter, trying to set up interviews for the young woman accusing me of rape. Let me tell you how dumb Kelvin is. I served Danny Astoria first, and the lawyer responded saying she represents Danny Astoria and Kelvin Hunter. A hit dog will holler, won't he? Then Kelvin's lawyer sent me a cease and desist telling me to stop talking about Kev. I hadn't even started talking about him yet, but I am talking now. And salute to Philip Jordan as well, a.k.a. Phil Gates. Phil, you allegedly were helping Kev with this. Phil is like 400 pounds. I think Kev promised him gastric bypass or lipo or something, but in typical Kelvin fashion, he didn't keep his word on that. He'd rather spend that money on his side chick. Bought her a Ferrari as a push present, but that car, according to the Daily Mail, got repossessed the day after Wendy announced the divorce. You know you can't afford those type of toys, Kev. All right, you could have gave that money to Phil to have his surgery. Instead of the repo man taking the Ferrari away, the doctors could have taken Phil's stomach away. But that is why we are here today. We are here to talk about this restaurant called the Karma Cafe, where there are no menus. You get served what you deserve. And Kev, you deserve everything that's happening to you right now, because you do understand everything that you attempt to do to someone has already been done to you. Let me repeat, whatever negative you are trying to do to someone has already been done to you. You were so busy trying to get me fired. And look, according to People magazine, Wendy Williams' husband, soon to be ex-wife, Kelvin Hunter, is being fired as her manager and executive producer of the TV show amid this divorce scandal. Kelvin, you so busy trying to curse others that you ended up cursing yourself. Did you really think you could go around treating people the way you treat them and not suffer any consequences from the universe all these years? The sad part is you treat everybody like doo-doo, but the one person you treat like doo-doo that you should never treat like doo-doo is your soon to be ex-wife. Bro, you are nothing without her. I know it hurts when people walk up to y'all and say, we love you, Wendy Williams, and you don't hear them say Wendy Williams Hunter, but nobody cares about no damn Hunters. Hunting season is over, all right? Do you think people give a damn if Wendy's last name is Hunter? You should have took the last name Williams, all right? If you think people didn't respect you when you was with Wendy, how do you think they're gonna feel about you now, okay? All the more reason you should have been kissing Wendy's feet and not Sharina Hudson's ass, okay? This is why from now on, Kelvin Hunter from Brownsville will be known as Doodoo Brown. Okay? Listen. Not because of the gay allegations from Avion Foster. I don't weaponize gayness because gayness is not to be weaponized. If he's allegedly bisexual, that's his business. I don't give a damn. We call him Doodoo Brown because he's always doing way too much. All right, I introduced you to Sharina Hudson back in the day. I don't remember the year. And in typical Kelvin Hunter fashion, he started doing too much. Made Sharina 12 years a side chick, using his allowance that he gets from Wendy to help her live the lavish life, had a baby with her. And that ultimately cost you your marriage and every valuable, genuine relationship that you had in your life. You threw it all away for a woman that wasn't your wife. If you are not the epitome of doing too much, I don't know what is. And it's only a matter of time before Sharina leaves you. Oh, don't think she's staying around. Wendy not taking care of y'all no more. Okay, whatever you get from Wendy, Sharina gonna get a bunch of that in child support. Oh, wait for it. It's coming. All right, same thing you did to Wendy, Sharina gonna do to you with another man. Guaranteed. But I just wanna say, Kelvin, I wish you the best. I really do. He's a hurt person, and hurt people hurt people. Kelvin needs healing, and we all know if you don't heal what hurt you, you'll bleed on people who didn't cut you. All you do is bleed on people who have never cut you. Wendy didn't cut you, you bled on her. Charlamagne didn't cut you, you bled on me. Avion, well, If what he says is true, y'all cut each other and there probably was blood. But that's neither here nor there. I pray that you find some healing and this is not the legacy you leave for your son or your daughter. Sir, get on your knees and repent for your sins. Get your soul right. Go to therapy. I saw your lame-ass apology yesterday that you didn't write, but understand that the best apology will always be changed behavior. And I just don't see you changing, but I hope for the sake of your kids, you do. My brothers out there, do right by your wives. Especially when your wife is the primary breadwinner. Guys, this is yet another example of no good coming to a man because he didn't do right by his wife. Black men don't cheat, and it's very important to note that Kelvin Hunter, a.k.a. Doodoo Brown, was raised in Brownsville, but he was born in Canada, okay? The moral of the story is, Kelvin, never bite the hand that feeds your side chick. Please let Remy Ma give Kelvin Hunter the biggest hee-haw.
Hee-haw, hee-haw, you stupid motherfucker, are you dumb?
Breaking news, too.
Wow.
What? This just in.
What? That was an extended donkey.
When it rains, it pours.
What happened? What?
Allegedly.
Okay.
The man accusing Kelvin Hunter of sexual assault, Avion Foster, is pregnant. I don't know if this is true.
Shut up, man. Shut up.
I don't know if this is true.
Shut
this
up.
Is all alleged.
Shut up.
I don't know if this is true. It just came across the wire.
You're stupid.
He just came across the
wire. That's not true.
He's really born in Toronto?
Black
no,
men
he
don't
said
cheat.
Canada.
Only, Canada?
Canadian black men don't count. He was born in, I don't know if he was born in Toronto.
You just made that up.
No, I didn't. I saw that on somewhere. No, same source I got from Avion Foster being pregnant.
No.
He's stupid,
he
man.
He pulled out.
By Kelvin Hunt.
He pulled out.
Definitely.
Oh, gosh.
One time for Doodoo Brown, though. When you see him in the street, say, what's up, Doodoo Brown?
Doodoo Brown!
Hey! Doing too much from Brownsville.
All right.
Charlemagne the God here, and today's Donkey of the Day is brought to you by the Law Office of Michael S. Lamonsoff. Don't be a donkey and call my friend Michael if you've been hurt in a construction accident. 212-962-1020. That's 212-962-1020. Don't be a donkey.